It's just giving me a place where I can come and share my ideas and not be judged and share my faith about God and spread my faith about God, because there's not a lot of places in school that you can do that.
Mm-hmm. How has it helped you as an athlete, too?
It's given me supreme confidence over everything. I mean, always knowing that someone's watching over me and has my back up through everything, it's just made me play harder and play better.
Mm-hmm. God's word, too. You know, the way FCA presents it, has it been pretty effective for you?
Yeah, I mean, it's given me everything I needed. I mean, I can read a Bible and be ready to go before game. I have a Bible verse I read before every game. Joshua 1:9, it's always ready to go.
Be strong and courageous.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. How about, too, when it's peer-to-peer, when you guys break off into small groups, how powerful is that for you?
It helps me connect more with the people and teach them more about God than more than I know and they know before lessons, and it helps just bring us tighter together through God.
Rockridge, you know, has a cool history with FCA. I think like Ethan was involved in it when he helped started. I mean, how much is that move you to lead and to be one of those guys to make sure this thing is sustained?
I got started through my brother Nathan, and it's just carried on through there. I mean, when that whole Drake deal went down, everything was tight knit and close, and I started with FCA, and it just made me closer with God.
Mm-hmm. A lot of kids walk in the hallways who might be a little fearful of what it would be like to be part of this group. What's your challenge and encouragement to them?
Just show up, and I guarantee you, you'll learn something. Even if it's not what you want to learn, you'll learn something, and you'll take away something from each meeting, and you'll go closer with God. Even if you haven't and didn't know God, you'll find Him.
It's made it so I can meet more friends and expand my friend zone. I've also become more religious and more involved with Christ.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what happens here on Fridays. What are some things other kids who don't attend, what could they expect?
You could come. We usually have a breakfast buffet in the morning, which helps bring in more students. And then we usually have a fun activity. We do like a game that relates to our lesson we're going to have planned, that the leadership's planned. And then we do our lesson, and then we pray.
Why is it so important for you and for other kids to lock into a faith in Christ as you, not only as an athlete, but a student, and just live in life, too?
It just helps you understand the more detailed parts of life, and that everything kind of happens for a reason, and that you can just believe in Christ and keep going through your life.
Mm-hmm. FCA has a wonderful history and beginning here. You know, just talk about, too, how important it is for you to maintain that legacy, that, you know, that you guys want to keep it going, and you're taking great steps to do that.
Yeah, it's really important to bring in incoming freshmen and incoming sophomores, because sophomores can drive and they can bring the freshmen. But it's important that you keep bringing more kids in, otherwise it's going to become a smaller group like it once was.
Mm-hmm. Do you find yourself thinking differently because you have this during the week, you know, not just church, but you have FCA too, and you're opening up the Bible?
Yeah, it's a little bit different than going to church. It's more laid back and relaxed, and I feel like I can open up more to my peers than I can to, like, my grown adults at church.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that when you guys break off into small groups, I mean, what's that dynamic like for you?
We sit there and we just kind of like talk about the lesson and how it's important to us and how it relates to our actual life and our sports life as well as our academic life.
Mm-hmm. And last thing, you know, what's your message to kids who might be a little fearful of being in a group like this?
There's nothing really to fear, because when you come here, it's like a family and you just get involved so quickly that it's really easy to just fall right into the steps.
It was quite a few years ago that I had a student approach me and say, hey, do you want to do this? And I thought, oh, I don't know if I have the time. I don't have the energy. I've got kids at home. But honestly, it's been worth every minute with them. My kids, they come to our leadership team meetings, and they get to see all these, you know, big kids, our high schoolers, just living the word, and it's really awesome to see every week.
How powerful is it, you know, when you do, you open the Bible together in leadership, and then on Fridays it unfolds? So.
Well, you know, we look at everything, and the kids have a great time, you know, planning the lessons. And today, you know, there are certain groups that are in charge each week of what our lesson is going to be, and it's really neat to see them apply the message and, you know, just work together as a team.
Mm-hmm. You are in the middle of the teen culture, too. I mean, how crucial is it to have something like this?
I think it's a great way for kids to, you know, come together and just preach kindness. It's a different world that we live in these days, and every Friday we are working together basically to spread the word and build a culture that's not hateful.
Mm-hmm. And last thing, for that person who says never, never, never in a million years would I want to do this. And like you said, I don't have time. I mean, why should they take that leap of faith to lead a huddle?
Honestly, it's the relationships you have with these kids. I see them in the classroom. They get to see me as the mean teacher. And then I come here on Fridays, and then it's a whole different ball game. I get to watch them grow from freshman to senior. Some of them I wouldn't see otherwise in the hallways. So it's really neat to have those relationships.
Mm-hmm.